Let us think, what is the reality? When I see with my eyes, if I remember your image, your face, your appearance, then what is this? I remember your appearance, your facial expression, and your presence. With the help of my eyes, I remember your voice. When you speak, I recognize through my ear that it is you are. When I touch you, whatever I feel, then I recognize it is you are. And when you say something, I remember it. I remember your phone number, your address, wherever you are. I remember all those things. Then what are these things? This is all our illusion. And people are stuck in this illusion. If you don't remember phone numbers and name of the person and address where you went, you don't remember it. It means we are not accepting the truth. Therefore, the visual perception, audio perception, tactile, smell, taste, everything. And memory, whatever I have memory, I have read a book, I remember it, I can teach it, I can write it, I can do thesis. This is all, this activity is called display of illusion. Then what is the truth? Truth is only one. I am potential child of God. You are potential child of God. Visual universe is child of God. Okay, this is truth what we listen. But what is education? How to experience it? The moment we experience that I am potential child of God, then how I will feel? I will feel I am omnipresence. Then I can work anywhere, anytime. I can do whatever I want. This is called truth. But people are stuck in this. Now my memory is going down. I am old age. I forget phone numbers. Something is happening bad. I am losing my memory. This is, it means I want to accept illusion as a truth. This is the biggest stress point in our life. Try to remember it. For your kind consideration, I remember only few faces. I meet 1,000 persons in all over the world, many 100,000s. I have met, I have served them, we know each other, but try to say that, do you recognize anyone? Honestly, very few numbers I can count on my fingers. Because I have no interest in recognizing face. I have no interest in recognizing their ID. I have only one reality that I know you are potential child of God. If I have to recognize you, then I must see that you are child of God. Within you, there exists all character of God. Power, knowledge, peace, immortality. This is. Therefore, try to remember this. This is very important. Regarding this contact lens, I want contact lens because through the eyes I want to see clearly. We don't need it. You can use contact lens when you are driving, when you are reading, when you have to do some external activities. In practice kriyaga, we don't need it. You need glasses during practice kriyaga, we don't need it. If from there you are not able to see me, doesn't matter. But if I am writing something on board, you want to see, then you need contact lenses or you need added glasses. Otherwise, we don't need it. This is important point we should remember. Suppose that you are reading a book and you don't remember it. Do not have stress. Try to remember one thing. We are potential child of God and try to prove it. When you prove it, by concentrating on head to toes, accepting it more and more, this is what we want. But you know, in all over the world, people are fighting on this issue. If you remember any book, you are able to reproduce as such, you are genius. No, it is not the symptom of genius. in through internet, computer science is able to represent more than what I am able to represent. Then computer technology is much more having greater memory, greater art of presentation than what I have it. But computer is created by us. Internet is discovered by us. And people in all over the world, they have this kind of worry. Therefore, very important, practice yoga meditation sincerely with all devotion.